This is a question taken from Code Forces Latok in round 1. It is a division 1 plus division 2 contest. And we will take the question C of it, which is a little Alovance puzzle. So in this question, we are given a puzzle of 2 into n grid. So basically there are 2 rows and n columns. And each of the row is a permutation of the numbers from 1 to n. The puzzle is said to be solved if the values in each row, I mean in each column of the two rows, are different. For example, we can see the test case 2. The given permutations or the given array is solved initially itself. So we need to find the number of swaps we can make in the array such that it still remains solved. So a swap can be done between the two rows of a single column. So we can swap 2 and 3 such that it becomes 3 and 2. So we can see the test case 2 here. If we swap 2 and 3 and 3 and 2, it still remains solved. Similarly, if we swap 6 and 8 and 8 and 6, it remains solved. So we'll see that how we can calculate the total number of swaps or the number of ways in which the swaps can be done so that the puzzle remains solved. So in test case 2, we are given something like this. We form a graph with the help of the given nodes with the given values, and a node will consist of a pair of values of a column. So this is our first pair of nodes. So when we form the graph, we get such a graph. So it is very clear that if we swap the values of each connected component, the puzzle remains solved. So if we swap 2 and 3 and 3 and 2, it remains solved. 6 and 8 and 8 and 6, it remains solved. Similarly, if we swap these 5, 1, 4, 7 with 7, 5, 1, 4, it remains solved. So the total number of ways in which we can swap the values is the sum of all the combinations, 3c1 plus 3c2 plus 3c3, which is indeed 2 to power 3, that's 8. So by observation, we can see that it is the number of connected components is 3. So we just need to calculate the number of connected components or the number of cycles in the graph. And with the help of it, we can calculate the total number of swaps. With the help of 2 to power n, we can find the number of connected components or the number of cycle with the help of DFS and thus proceed to the answer. Now we'll write the code for the same. We'll take the t test cases as input, we'll run a loop through it, take the number of columns as input, and then form our array. Then we need to form our adjacency matrix from it. We can take a global adjacency matrix so that we can use it in our DFS function as well. We'll see the constraint and make the vector accordingly. We'll form a visited array as well. Since there are more than one test cases, we'll clear the adjacency matrix also. Now we'll form the adjacency matrix with the help of the two arrays. We have formed our adjacency matrix. Now we'll find the number of connected components with the help of DFS. Finally, we have found the connected components, and now we need to print the answer. I have written a power function beforehand. It is a binary modular power function. Okay, so we'll now submit the code and try it. So the code is accepted.